comes to working with fluids and the collision of objects, we must take into account the important concepts when the fluid collides with geometry. We are going to generate a simple scene with a circular emitter, a K volume, and geometry so that the fluid can collide against it. When we simulate, the fluid is not colliding by default with the geometry. This is because it is necessary to add the RealFlow collider tag to the geometry to indicate that it is going to collide against the fluid. We are going to slightly adjust the visualization of the fluid and the K volume to better see the particles. Characteristics to be able to work with fluids inside RealFlow inside Cinema 4D is that we can modify the parameters and also the position of the geometry during simulation time to see how it reacts to the fluid. Any geometry we add to the scene and want to collide with our fluid needs to include the RealFlow collider tag. Selecting the geometry collider tag by visualizing Show Collision Geometry, the mesh of the collision of this geometry. This geometry is going to indicate the mesh with which the fluid will be colliding, and from the parameter we will be able to adjust the cell size and surface offset within the object parameters. Depending on the results of the mesh collision, the fluid will behave one way or another. It is important to take into account that with very low cell size values to adjust the mesh, the simulation times will be longer. By default, these parameters are in auto mode. That is to say that it is RealFlow which calculates the cell size and surface offset for the geometry. When we add geometry with a related structure, both the father and the children must have the RealFlow collider tag, so that the fluid can see each and every one of the geometries. Assigning the collider tag to all the children is just as easy as indicating that we wish to extend the tag to all the children that are related to this geometry.